Oh, where'd he go?
Oh.
Trevor.
He's dropping some poo-poo-ee! Dude, you need a bran muffin or something. Get some fiber in your diet. Miss me!
No one's listening, Trevor! No, thank you!
Did you just say you get all the fiber out of your pants?
That I can.
Oh.
Maybe you need the ear dildos.
I do need ear... hearing thingy mabobbers. I can't hear shit.
Trevor! Trevor!
What?
Leonard needs ear dildos.
Deny.
Oh shit. That was my bad hand, you twat.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, gosh. I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Put that on your YouTube channel.
How did you know about that?
You told me about it.
You're on it.
Hello, world. You still fucking mess.
Nice mess, Trevor. I'm not gonna hit her in the face with a roll of toilet paper. Maybe an asshole, but I'm not that much of a dick.
Look at all this mess.
I can make the mess a lot
Are you
worse.
Waiting for me or are you waiting? Oh. God. Were you just in my room?
Why are you ripping the paper? Ripping? Why are you ripping the paper?
Rip it?
Trying to take the fucking light out.
I know, we got toilet paper up
there. I'm gonna pick it up. I'm actually picking it up. Don't throw anything at me.
Yeah, come on. Let's be adults here, people.
Adults, we're in a fucking madhouse. That word doesn't...
Oh, you're such an asshole.
Oh, shit.
Dickhead, you have all your horrible.
I'd make a comment, but he'd feel bad.
This is how we decorate.
I'm picking them up.
Then put down one in the restroom!
Where it belongs! That's not the restroom.
You fucking kidding me?
Yes,
dude, I'm gonna teepee your door so you can't get out.
Okay, I'm leaving. Trevor's a weirdo who talks to people while they're pooping.
Can you hear me now?
What's the name? We're gonna have a discussion why we should ban cell phones in the restroom.
You shut your mouth.
You know, most of this
hey,
one's gonna be
Trevor,
about...
Hey, Trevor! Can you help me out with my vlog for a second?
Why are you recording me as you ask this question?
Because I want you to tell people what I tagged you in last night on Facebook. Okay, so you missed the part where he yelled at me to fuck off, but hang on, I'm gonna find it and then I'll show you. Okay, so Trevor he's like always laughing in his room. I don't know what he's laughing at, but it's always really weird to like sit in my room and all of a sudden hear him laugh at himself. So, hang on. So I found this video and I wrote, this is what I think every time I hear you in your room laughing to yourself, weirdo. I'll play it. So yeah, that's what he sounds like every time he laughs. Not really, but I just like to pick on him. Okay, so in all seriousness, we're having like this mandatory workshop that we have to go to just basically like about battling racism and discrimination on college campuses. So, yeah. Okay. Goodbye. So, we just got back from the mandatory meeting thing about racism and all that not fun stuff. Right now, I'm just waiting for that October block to stop, or to finish saving onto my computer, because I have to save it before I can go and upload it onto Words. Words are hard. Before I can upload it onto YouTube, and right now it's 98% complete. 99%. So, once that's done... Oh! It just finished. I'll have to proof watch it and then go on to YouTube, upload it, and then process it, and then make it go live. And then I can start editing this one. Well, I won't edit it till later because I don't know if any shenanigans are happening tonight. I really hope you can hear that in the background. I don't know, I'm gonna have to wait. But that's Jake. He's a unique character here. But Trevor's unique too, but just in a weird Irish way. Irish shenanigans. So, yeah. Okay, so you know how I showed you about the goat video earlier? Well, we're doing a little prank now where we're gonna tape that onto his door. So, yeah. Knocking on my window. And I can't.
Is that Heather?
It sounds like it. Alright, no, she's coming. Okay. Okay, so now we're using the tape. And I almost put it on my nose.
You don't have to vlog this whole process if you don't want to.
Oh, it's fucking cold out. I'm not opening the window.
I just wanted to talk to you for like 2 seconds. Can I have some booze tonight?
Hang on. Well, come in here for a second.
Is there gonna be say no?
What?
So, we're gonna do a prank.
On who?
On Trevor. We're gonna put prank. This on his door. Okay, now you can have this back. I'm sorry.
Oh, fuck! Fuck!
Anything
can you
like.
Leave me my gumption?
What?
Can you leave me my gumption and just take the Smith?
Apparently they know what whiskers on kittens and all
men smells like. I have no idea.
So they must clear you.
That sneaky fucking Irish bastard, he wasn't even in there.
Are you filming yourself?
I am filming myself because I'm fucking pissed.
Being mad. You're too cute to be mad.
It was funny. He didn't even get mad.
Are you trying to make him mad?
Here. Josh's room. Here. Why aren't you mad? Here. Huh? By the way, I now have on video that you're a sneaky fucking Irishman. Because we thought you were in the bathroom this whole time.
You're really gonna fucking video my goddamn dirty ass.
This is my happy place. This is the happy place.
There's no more booze, man.
It's okay, I'm still drunk.
too.
Ready to hear the best song that I've ever written in my life?
Peach yes. juice.
Okay.
Peach juice.
I'm addicted to tobacco and I've been gaining weight, but I hope that you can still see my love for you. If I could be as perfect as I think you deserve, then baby, you know that's what I had to do. And I got peach juice dripping down my chin, but I hope that you still wanna kiss me. And I got peach juice dripping down my chin, but I hope that you still wanna kiss me. I ain't as productive as I'd like to be.
Just do not lean forward.
Okay, I won't lean forward.
Kiwi.
Mm-hmm.
Hi. You can't even see the fact that you're glaring.
It's bright.
What are you doing?
Blogging. Pinky up.
See what happened? I almost choked on it.
Good.
Wow! Wow! That shows how much you care! Not at all.
Yeah. Burp. Feel the burn.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ!
Hey guys. Sorry I didn't vlog at all yesterday. I just really nothing too interesting happened. And woke up, did dish chores, intended to clean my room and pack a little bit, and then I fell asleep. And then, yeah, that was pretty much it. And then this morning, woke up, did dish chores. But this afternoon, Heather and I are going out. We're supposed to go to Bar Hill and I guess go to Hardwick. So hopefully we'll get some interesting videos going or something. I don't know. So I'm with Heather.
Hi!
Again. And we are hiking up Bar Hill.
Yes. Not Berry Hill. Bar. B-A-R-R.
B-A- okay. Yeah. Heather insisted that it's a very beautiful place and that she had to show me before we all leave, so, yeah.
And it's a nice day.
And it's a beautiful day.
There's no one here. Like, I don't know, man. Are they planning an air raid that I haven't been told about?
That's gonna happen on Bar Hill.
In the middle of fucking nowhere, Vermont. Yup.
Yup. Look at that view already. I don't even think my phone's justifying it.
They never do.
Goddamn. Well, take my word for it. It's very beauteous. Okay.
And that's... So we're seeing almost to Rutland. That's fucking amazing.
Wow.
Honestly. That just blows my mind.
Your viewers better appreciate that.
And then over here on the other side of the trees... Or Spruce Mountain and Signal Mountain in Groton State Forest. I've been up on top of a couple mountains in Groton, but not those two. I went up Big Deer and Little Deer, barefoot with my dog.
Your accent's coming out again.
I know. We ended up letting her off leash because there were these literal boulders we had to climb up that were like this high, and I'm like, you can do this better than I can. I'll just go for it, Allie. And she did great. She did better than I did. But very rocky mountains and really, really, really hard on your feet and knees going up and down those. Like, even if I weren't barefoot, I think it would have been hard. But anyway, yeah.
Onward march. Okay.
Let me see if I can find my reference because it's not exact. I think that's Elmore with Bolton to the right of it and Ricker to the left. And that's Dewey. And yeah, that's definitely Mansfield. I can see the outline of the face. Madonna Peak all the way next to the tree line. And then on this side we have... Where's Camel's Hump? It's way in the back. Like, you could barely see it. Do you see it?
No. All I see is the sun burning my retinas. Oh, way, way in the back.
Way in the back, yeah.
Yeah.
And it's shaped like this.
Yeah.
That's Camel's Hump. That's our second highest peak in Vermont. I've been to the top of it. I've been to the top of Mansfield, too, but I cheated.
How did you cheat?
They have a toll road, and I drove up most of the way.
Heather.
My knees can't handle that. I'm an old lady. Leave me alone.
You're not that old. Come on.
Well, thank TJ Maxx for that. My knees. Thank you, Mrs. R. Anyway.
Okay, back Worcester to the Mountain. View.
Worcester Mountain, Mount Hunger. Mount Abraham is kind of in the back there. Bald Mountain. Oh, we have two Bald Mountains in Vermont. Okay. Bald Mountain is not quite all the way in the background, right there, kind of nestled in between. Little pokey thing.
The little pokey thing.
Oh, there's Breadloaf to the left of Bald Mountain, and then this one in the foreground is Woodbury Mountain. It's also called Buffalo Mountain, apparently. I don't know.
Where do they? Where? Why? What?
Well, camel's hump is because it looks like a camel's hump.
Well, that I understand.
I don't know. Because we have, you know, the great Vermont buffalo herds. Come on.
All the time. All the time. All the buffalo.
Wow, Killington's that way, huh? Okay, yeah, Killington's that way.
Okay.
So hemlocks have this neat thing. It's resin. Oh. Where did it go? It's resin. And it's used as a protective measure against critters. And it doesn't taste very good. Yeah. But the idea is, this is my idea, this is my theory. My, Heather Cullen, this is my theory. This stuff, it's not really toxic, but it doesn't taste good. Hemlock has it in pockets on the outside, right under the bark, where other trees have it, like, under the bark, but, like, not in pockets. Like, it just goes up and down. And it's not the same as sap, because sap carries nutrients. This is purely a defense mechanism. And I was wondering, like, why the hell, why would they put it in pockets? Like, it doesn't seem to make a lot of sense to me. And then I found this one website, I can't remember what it was, but it was written by a Vermont state forester. So I trust him. Maybe I shouldn't. And he said that it was for defense. And I was like, okay, that's cool, but why? And I was walking through the cedar swamp, like a week ago, and I go and I pop one of these things, and it comes out super quick and gets all over my hands, and I'm like, if I were a bird, because it startled me, I wasn't expecting it. If I were a bird, and I did that, if I were pecking on this tree, and it did that, and got on my hand, or not my hand, but it got on my face. If it got on my face.
Birds have hands.
They do. Watsons have hands.
But if it got on your face.
Yeah, so, yeah. Like, not only would the sudden movement startle me, but, like, it getting on me, like, I'd just be like, fuck this, I'm out. And so, yeah, I think that's what it is. I think it's just a thing that worked for them really well, and it keeps avian predators away because their birds are, this is a terrible pun and I don't mean it to be a pun, but the birds are flighty. They are. They won't stick around if they think they're in danger because they have a very quick, very efficient method of escaping. So there's no reason for them to. That's all over me.
And that was Heather Cullen's theory.
Yeah, that's my theory. That's, yeah. Plus, if it landed in their eyes or their nares, their nostrils, it could be, like, really bad. And I don't know about you, but it really only takes me getting weird shit in my eye once for me to learn from that. Like, that's not something that needs to be repeated. I gotta get this taste out of my mouth.
Oh, okay. I'm just doing a quick sweep around. Just in case there are people who have never seen forests like this before. Like desert people.
Coniferous forest.
Coniferous forest. That's gonna be like the one of the biggest things I'll miss.
Coniferous forest?
Yeah.
Yeah. But you can go up north and see the fucking redwoods and that's awesome.
Yeah. Alright, I gotta tell my mom we gotta do that. Yeah. Mom,
I'm the next Mr. Wizard.
Go ahead.
This is called haircat moss. It's either in the genus Atricum or Polytricum. And I don't have a hand lens, so I'm not going to be able to tell you which right now. But these are kind of like the pioneer moss for shaded, moist soils. And after these guys have been established for a while, we get this stuff, which is called feather moss, and it's either in the genus Hypnum or Tilum. And it likes it a little bit wetter, because the moss, what it does really well is collects and retains moisture. So when it's moist enough from the Atricum and Polytricum, these guys move in and they start forming a thing. And then once these guys have made it super moist, we get sphagnum.
Am I sitting on it?
There might not be any right here. Everybody calls it sphagnum, and I don't like that. It's Svanium. There might not be some at this site.
Holy crap. I got distracted by the view again.
Yeah.
Are we, like, in Narnia?
We might be. Let me know if you see a fawn.
Mr. Thomas?
Thomas?
Wow, I've been saying it wrong my whole life. I thought it was just Mr. Thomas.
Trespassing.
So Heather and I found a building over here, and we're gonna be nosy and see if, like, maybe there are dead bodies hidden there or something. Because that's how horror movies start. You know what I also realized? There aren't that many natives in horror movies.
Nope.
Because we're smart. As we say as we walk towards the mysterious building.
Yeah.
It's so pretty.
Come on, buddy. Talk to us.
Get angry. That wasn't the squirrel, that was Heather. Oh. It sounded so close. Where are you? I can't find it, Heather.
It's over here.
It's hard to walk and not drop a phone at the same time.
Yeah, please don't drop it. It's not a terribly great case. It doesn't have a warranty on it.
Okay, well, it's being shy, so. But look how pretty it is. I like the darker kinds of.
You would have loved Moose Bog. It was amazing.
Well, I'll just have to come back and visit then.
Yes.
Okay.
I've never been out here, actually. We passed by it the last time.
Oh my god.
I think.
Like, your phone is so much more better quality than mine, but it still doesn't even do it justice.
No. I know. So pretty.
If I wasn't so out of shape, I'd want to climb those mountains. But I'm too fat for that right now. One day.
You can work on it.
Work on it, yep. Mm-hmm.
Dude, I didn't just get up one day and decide I was going to climb Camel's Hump. I climbed a bunch of different mountains all summer and then went to Camel's Hump in September.
There's really no mountains to go hiking on Cape Cod, though. We have sand dunes.
You can still walk. And walking in sand is actually, it's better conditioning because walking in sand is fucking hard. Like, it's harder than just walking around on the street or on dirt that or whatever. Because it gives a lot. Try running in sand. That shit will wear you out so fast.
There was a, I forget what her name was, but there's this Olympic swimmer, and, like, I guess she's from Hawaii, and she goes running with huge boulders underwater on the sand.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
That'll definitely beef up your thighs.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, Kat.
I just caught you saying that. Oh, my God.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god, that's so beautiful, like, even with all the clouds and everything.
You see that.
See what? Oh my goodness. Huh?
It's like a podium. It's here just for me.
For your butt.
For my butt. Just for my butt.
And we're gonna sit and watch the sunset.
Yeah, because we got a few minutes before we have to leave.
Yeah. Okay, goodbye.
Because you've been dead. I'm like, yeah, I still miss you. I'd come back and visit you. Alright, what are you doing? Are you filming?
And it's so simple, too.
And of course, they stopped singing. Of course.
Trevor's gone. I don't have the abilities.
Let me see. I'm sure it'll bring me more.
You're trying to get her.
Well, I can play this on guitar. I kind of like play along.
47
days. Okay, so the very first thing is a corkscrew shaped like a hammerhead shark.
Let me
what
see.
Does that have to do with cock? What does...
Let me see. Shark cock.
No. Why? What does that have to do with cock? That has nothing to do with cock.
Heather?
What?
My mom watches these.
Hi, Cat's mom. I might meet you. I really hope that you let me stay in your house. You foul.
That has nothing to do with a penis.
Exactly, nothing at all.
Not a penis.
I am a good influence on your daughter.
She is.
Despite what it might look like.
Yes,
right now.
Andrew. Yes, she is. Just drink and be quiet. Drink and be quiet.
I mean,
there you go. There you go. Okay.
Possums have two heads. On their penises, yes.
Oh, yeah.
I realize, like...
Echidnas have four.
No, echidnas have five.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, so when I played WoW, there was a gun in the game that had, like, five barrels.
Spencer, sing. Sing.
And you put the load right on me.
Yeah, it's looking busy. It's $50 a week.
Andrew. Hi.
The population is
90%
for
seniors. Oh my god. Oh yeah. It's Kiwi. And Josh is... Oh.
Your hand?
My hand. Oh no! Let me see it. I got you, boo.
Wait, you hit me again with your hand?
I did.
What about her hand?
I'm sorry! I'm sorry! I'm sorry!
Oh, Kiwi! Uh-huh. It's a good thing your mom didn't name you Grace. Shut up, Josh.
It's like beading water.
Oh.
Ready?
What are they called again?
Puffballs.
Ah!
Oh. Those are spores.
Ooh. Ooh.
Whoa, this one's... Holy crap, look it. Still going.
Oh, man. Oh. Okay then.
Oh wow! Damn, Kiwi. You were having way too much fun with that.
I got shroom spores all over my shirt now.
I have it.
Good.
What is that? Mushrooms? It was mushrooms.
Was. Then Josh happened.
Oh, what do you want me to do?
Put your hand in there.
The
why?
Why not?
Why don't you thrust your hand in the hole?
I'm just, no
what's
problem.
In there?
A whole lot of nothing.
A whole lot of nothing.
Oh,
shit!
Okay, I'm leaving.